went underneath him and snuck between the foot and the goalpost. It was Shepherd who forced the turnover there. I believe Castetonoff, the defenseman, turned it over. There was the pass that banked in right there. He actually almost kicked it in, it looked like, on that angle himself with his left foot, but it went underneath the goal stick between his feet. It's Fetisov, number two, and Castetonoff, number seven, there. Bang. There it is, right between the legs, and he kicked it in his own net. Trober to get credit for the goal. Now that line just kept pressuring and pressuring and kept the puck in. And Stefan Richer, who has scored 50 goals before in this league for the Montreal Canadiens, makes no mistake. Goes to the backhand underneath the right pad of Chevalier. As Lipscomb's got the left winger tied up in front of the net. And that ties it at one. Kevin Todd was the man that was hit by Peter Stastny. Point blank range, and look at this miss by Maley. Whiff. Nothing there. The other end, if the pass from Shepherd doesn't hit Fedorov in the back of the foot, they got a clean two-on-one. As a result of that, it ended up one-on-one. And opportunities. And Chevalier just looking behind it to make sure it hadn't.
I think that's the only reason the goal judge turned the light on.
You're not kidding. That's what I mean about changing his clothes in a phone booth. I mean, he had nowhere to go. And watch this replay. I mean, this is incredible. Einzelbart couldn't touch this puck off the bench. It had to hit a New Jersey player first. And look what he does here. I mean, there's two guys there. There's relatively no space at all. And somehow he found a way to creep between the two guys and make it a 2-1 hockey game.
Eisenman getting his 16th.
Danico was the defenseman.
And he walks out in front. Claude Fillgrain, who was born in Haiti and was originally drafted by the Red Wings back in 82.
Well, he gets his 7th goal. And we're tied again with 2:09 to go in the period. There was a penalty being called to Konstantinov. A delayed call. Jimmy Carson getting there just too late, and that line's been on for both New Jersey goals. There's the hold. You can see it, Konstantinov going out of your pitcher. And the delayed call in progress, but not to be, as Vilgrain ties the hockey game.
Born at Port-au-Prince, Haiti.
The Rangers hit the road following Sunday night's game with the Bruins. Boston, they were coming off a Saturday night loss against Philadelphia. Roger Nielsen seeing a sight he doesn't normally see. Sharpshooter Mike Gartner, the open net, but gets stoned by Andy Moog. Oh, Gartner's reaction to this? The hands, what's wrong with the hands? Third period, Rangers up 2-0 off the rebound. Tony Amonte one-times it, his 12th of the year, 3-0 Rangers. 20 seconds later, Sergei Nemchinov with the breakaway. 4-0 Rangers. Big night for Mike Richter. Stopping Barry Peterson point blank. Richter records 30 saves, his second career regular season shutout. Also had one in the playoffs as the Rangers win it by the final of 4-0. The North Stars were at the stadium and Chicago wins it 7-2. Steve Larmer, his 7th career hat trick. The North Stars just 12 shots on goal, including 2 in the third period. The Devils and Flyers met for the 4th time this season. Overtime couldn't settle this one. The Flyers just 1-7-2 in their last 10 games, 1-10-3 versus Patrick Division foes. The Flames brought a 4-game winning streak into Buffalo, and you might recall the last time these two met in November, that was Pat LaFontaine getting his jaw broken. Tonight, the brawl started after a Tony Tassi slash in the first period, a 29-minute break in the action involving some other action. The Sabres' Brad Miller looking to take on the entire Flame bench. The way things have gone. Donald Audet and Gary Suter go at it. And then, you know, let's just have a nice, happy holiday, right? Flames, by the way, won this game by the final of 4-2. Gary Roberts had a couple of goals. 147 penalty minutes, 10 players were ejected, and Dave Snuggerud, his 2nd goal of the year. The league's best road team in Winnipeg.
Well, the last thing the Hawks wanted to see was an early goal by the Red Wings. And Fedorov made no mistake. He beat Belfour cleanly to the blocker's side. Fedorov breaking away from his own blue line, and he left Roenick standing still, basically. And Chicago had possession out at the top of the blue line inside the Red Wings zone, and all of a sudden, Fedorov. And indeed, if that hadn't happened, the faceoff would have come outside because it did not touch a Red Wing, I don't think, off the stick of Steve Smith.
The Fedorov goal may get 1-12 of the period, unassisted, his ninth of the year.
Fedorov taking a big hit from Rod Butkus, the former Probert. Four guys took a shot at Probert on that shift, and it took four hits to get Probert mad enough to take a shot at Dirk Graham.
Well, we were talking about it before the game, Mick. I'd be very surprised with Denny Biel out of the lineup if they don't try to get this guy, number 24, involved in a fight so that they know, in case there's a second one later in the game, if Probert's the instigator, he gets the automatic misconduct. And it's been the strategy, in particular, of the Blackhawks and the Blues when they play the Red Wings.
Now, I don't know what they're calling for penalties here. Jimmy Carson, he got bulldozed, I think, by Smith. There's Probert, gets nailed by Graham. He retaliates, bang. I don't know why Dirk Graham throws his jaw up like that. Watch Carson go down. Boom, he's nailed by Smith in the back and tries to get at Probert. Bodies flying everywhere. The temperature's rising. Here's Lemieux with Konstantinov. He got the leverage on Vladimir and really drilled him into the end board.
Back to Fedorov, it was not.
Out to center ice.
Lidstrom drops it back for McCrimmon. McCrimmon being challenged center ice by Roenick. Now Lidstrom back to McCrimmon. The Hawks very aggressive in their neutral zone. Checking of the wings. Here's Gallant trying to get a dive from it. Slides it across Belfort. Tips it away. Good job by Gallant to knock it away from Roenick. It comes down to Nicholas Lidstrom. He goes to Yzerman, back to Lidstrom. Quick pass across from McCrimmon. McCrimmon dumps it back behind Belfort. Fedorov lets it go. Yzerman picks it up out to Nicholas Lidstrom. Back to Yzerman. Now it comes to Gallant. He moves it to Fedorov. Fedorov behind the net. Took a chop there from Roenick. Back to the line for McCrimmon. McCrimmon let a pass go for Yzerman. Redirected it over the top of Belfort. Marchman sent it around the boards and over. Drops for Eisenbach. In front for Shepard. He hit the goal post. Larmer fails to clear. 10 seconds left to the man advantage. Racine lets the shot go just wide as Belfort was screened. Eisenbach in the corner. Takes it behind the net. Eisenbach looking out in front. Circles out. Out of the box comes Smith. Pass goes to Carson. Quick shot and a save by Belfort. It remains 1-0 Detroit as the action.
The last game in here. I remember we had a shot about Peluso on the bench was really getting it from Mike Keenan. Peluso went out there mad, got in the fight, got the instigator. Detroit scored a power play goal. And here he's going to go by himself with 3:25 to go. Yeah. Watch what happened here. Great opportunity by Racine. Top of the circles. It's Conroy, and there's Peluso, 44.
Watch the glove come on. Watch. Oh, no. See, I didn't hit him.
Well, just enough. Big Mike. He goes. This one set up by Ray Shepard. He pulls to a halt. He knew he had guys coming late. Finally, they get in position. Into Carson, to Racine. Boom. Right into the middle of Eddie Balfour.
And it remains 1-0. Well, they'd like to get Racine on track a little bit. He still has just the one goal this year.
That was way deep now for Carson. Carson back to the line for Shane. He'll move it across for Chiasson. Chiasson sets it up, shoots, and a save by Belfort. Puck is up on the air, recovered by Shepard in the corner. Out to the right point for Chiasson. Back to Shepard. Cross ice for Racine. In deep for Carson. Carson sends it back for Racine. Back in deep now for Probert. Probert lost his stick. Hawks clear it around. Chiasson holds it in. Takes the hit. Now the puck bounces loose. Hawks got it to the line. Good job by Racine. Carson, a drive save. Didn't quite get it up high enough. Fox cleared around, and Roenick able to dump it out to the center ice. 40 seconds left in this power play. It's been a good one again for Detroit. Racine across the line, drops it to Probert. Probert takes it into the corner. Back to the left point for Chiasson. Hunts the shot go that's blocked, and the Hawks able to clear a race for the puck. Larmer, he'll get there. Chiasson should have an angle on him. Larmer, backhand shot, a save by Shevelday. And Yzerman gives it up to Fedorov. Fedorov across the line. Left it there for Eisenbach. Cross ice, Yzerman. And was just in too close to the heel of his stick. Yzerman in the corner. Back
to the line for Lidstrom. Now Fedorov, tied up there by Chelios. 5 seconds left in the Paluso penalty, but the Wings with control. They keep them. Fedorov, Eisenbach, back to Eisenbach. Quick shot, tip, Belfort was saved, and there's no rebound there. Look at Chelios from behind on Fedorov. Fedorov and Chelios, a good hold of each other. The hitting, even a little bit after the whistle, but this running from behind, I'll tell you what,
I don't know if he got the cross check up or not.
Don't do that, Shelly.
That's the linesman's voice you hear. He said, don't do that, Shelly. Speaking of Chelios, I don't know what he was trying to do, whether it was scratching or whatever, or headbutting, but he drilled better off in the middle of the back of the neck. You know, Sergei's got his English in order there. He'd be telling Chelios about the next encounter. And Sergei's not afraid to do that. And again, part of the game plan. Have a look at it one more time. Deflection, Eisenbart. Watch the shot he took in the back of the head, right there.
Well, he got it
right
up between
the top of the neck. And away they go from there.
Well, it looks like from what we saw, 2 minutes each for roughing and maybe an extra two for cross-checking on Chelios.
Well, I don't think there's any question about that. There should be two and two to Chelios and a two to Fedorov. There's a miscue by Eisenman just off the heel of the stick. Tried to one-time it. Down to a minute 22 in the period. It's Carson drives it. Broberg gets a rebound underneath the right arm of Belfort and out the right side.
Opportunity there for Eisenman off the faceoff. Gallant with a hit on Steve Smith. Now Martin LaPointe pushed it up the board, but it's taken by Jocelyn Lemieux and sent back into the Red Wing zone. Dribble lay out of the net. Loops it up the board to Krimen. He knows that Peluso's coming. Loose puck back in the Chicago zone. Eisenman's got it with Gallant. Pants it fun and whipped by Gallant, held in by Lidstrom. Lidstrom sends it back in behind the Chicago goal. Eisenman has it there, gets the Hawks going one way, comes out the other. Still has it out in front. Lidstrom shot blocked in front. And the Hawks able to clear as Vincelette. That hit the linesman. Otherwise, the Hawks probably would have iced it. Just over half a minute left in this period as Gallant dumps it into the Chicago zone. Conroy plays it up the boards, taken center ice by Marsh. Marsh flips it back the other way. Corner on the far side of Belfort. Kayson along the boards into the corner for Gallant. Out in front, a good opportunity here for Racine, went just wide. Racine again now along the boards for Gallant, back to Racine. Racine chips it back to Gallant, he goes to Miller. Sends it to the corner, Roenick was there though, got it to the line, held in by Kayson. Nice play to get it to Racine, hits up, tip just wide of Belfort. Evan Miller on the redirection. Wings trying to keep the pressure on. Pass in front was blocked. 18 seconds left of the power play. Kayson lets a shot go that's blocked well wide of the net. Gallant rolls it back to Eisenman along the board. Eisenman fakes the pass. Gets it in the circle. His shot hit Gallant. And you see the time remaining on the power play. Wings with control. Kevin Miller rolls it in front. Deflects right out. A shot there by Gallant. And Belfort the save as the penalty to Hudson expires. And the Red Wing power play continues to threaten. But the Hawks keep the Red Wings. Made by Belfort. He took everything away from Eisenbach. Belfort likes to go down that butterfly, and he covers everything low. Here's Marsh across the line. Separated from the puck. Good play by Eisenbach to move up, but could not hold it in. Now Castantino drives it back into the Chicago zone. Chelios goes up the middle and Hudson tips it ahead. This should be an icing.
He doesn't make a real good fake to freeze Belfort. And Belfort did a good job just to come across with ball eyes apart. With those pads spread on the butterfly style, you got to go upstairs.
Conroy plays it around now. Noonan played it off of Lidstrom. The puck's still inside the Chicago zone. Now the Hawks. Conroy, last man back, just avoided Carson there. Back the other way now comes Tinelli. Tinelli gives it up for Noonan. His shot did not get through. Loose puck. Lidstrom ties up a Hawk. Here's Brent Sutter with an opportunity. Slapped away. Another chance for the Hawks. Backhanded
side by Noonan. Sutter chases it down on the corner, dumps it behind the Detroit goal. Noonan checked there by McCrimmon. McCrimmon plays it off the board. Lead pass, center ice, Shepherd open on the right side. He sends it across looking for Carson. It was intercepted, taken away by Shepherd. Wanted to get it back to Carson, who was going the other way. Pinelli plays it around the board. 1-0 Red Wings lead. Center ice, Noonan. Rides it behind Chevalier up the board. First one there, Eisenman able to tip it. Good job by Chelios, or did that hit the referee? I'm not sure which.
Yes, it did.
Here's Noonan. He tries to get loose. He's taken down by Chiasson, no call. 3-on-2 for Detroit. Eisenman, left wing pass now for Miller. Miller sends it back in front. Picked up by Fedek.
The net
is off the magnets, and Belfour makes the stop.
Again, same position, down. Plays it off the chest. They're up cheering on the Probert hit on Marchment. It remains 1-0.
After three opportunities, and it's 2-0 Detroit.
I think Eddie Belfour thought that Eisbart was going to go back to the forehand. He got it done with a deke. Nice play by Fedorov. He threaded the pass between two Hawks and right under the back of the stick of Eisenbart. A couple little stick handles. Looked like he froze Balfour that time. Watch his little moves right here. Right there, the two of them. And Balfour. It's the bench. He is not a... is he some upset? Holy mackerel. He's got kicking everything down the hallway. Get out of his way.
Now, Mike Keenan has made that move only to try to fire the rest of the team up. He's not trying to get Belfour that upset, because I don't think Belfour played that poorly. How can you blame him on two clean breakaway goals as you look at the numbers so far this year?
Size difference between he and Gallant, for sure. And then Smith ends up on top. That again, they went into the boards. The play came back the other way, and then the two of them just never got separated. And they'll go to the box probably for 5 minutes apiece. 7-6. Well, Mike Keenan's move backfires. Jimmy Waite's not supposed to be off that goalpost here. Carson got lots on it, but look at Waite. He's on his knees way too early. The puck hit him in the shoulder, I believe, and goes into the top corner. Right there. I think that may be his first shot on goal, wasn't it? First or second. And that goal's a long time. Young guy. He's frisky as all get out. He can play the game. And he just wants to play hockey. And that's an important part of any hockey club.
Now, Martin LaPointe, number 22. Is scheduled to leave tomorrow to join the Canadian national junior team for the World Junior Championships over in Germany. And Brian Murray knows that he's got the big goal, actually not shorthanded, because it was still
11 seconds left for McCrimmon.
And the McCrimmon penalties, it was four skaters aside. That's a big, big goal for the Hawks if they're going to have a chance to come back in this game.
See, right there, you see, Yves Racine came around, and Chiasson was already back there. That left two defensemen behind the net, and nobody in front to defend, and Vincelet gets the short. Jimmy Waite never saw the puck, and Jim Carson didn't even know it was in the net. He was darn near on his knees. Good play by Probert to headman the puck, and it's a two-on-one, basically. Carson pulls up, lets two Hawks go by, drills it. Waite is down again and went right up in the top corner. Hey, Waite, look around. He had no idea where it was.
You mentioned good play by Probert and a good little flip pass by Schmidt. 5-1.
Marchment really give it to Burr. As the goal was scored, he may have speared him. John Burr went down like he was shot.
Better off second of the night and 10th of the year.
It's Mark Bunta loses the puck. Watch Better off. He goes all over the place, back into the corner and back out in front. See if you can see what happens to Burr and Marchment. There was Marchment coming back in the left ear screen. I think he just took that stick and drilled Burr on the ankle.
Got it off a Red Wing player, but there was a Chicago player cutting in front as well, and that makes it 5-2 Detroit.
Yeah, Graham's trying to get the puck to his teammate over in front of the net, and it hit a Red Wing, changed direction, and Chevalier anticipated the pass, went to play it. The puck goes by his right side. Here's Graham. I think it's Brad McCrimmon that it hits. He's trying to get it to Sutter, and I'm not sure if Sutter got a piece of it or not. Here's a high angle look at it. Not McCrimmon, it's Lidstrom. Sorry, Brad. And there's the tip right there.
Off of
Bob Probert. And Sutter did not get his stick on it.
It should be Dirk Graham's goal.
And it will be his eighth of the year.
March out from behind his own net. Sends it ahead now for Kevin Miller. Miller on the move. Sends it right in front for a current opportunity to save by Wade.
Graham and Conley, the Hawks still can make this finish interesting with 3:28 to go. Chevalier did get a piece of it with the trapper. That thing rolling again. Came through like a knuckleball. Look at that thing turning over. Like it may have gone off the wrist of the catching glove. You know, kind of the thumb area, not enough of it for Tim Chevalier.
28.7 seconds to go, and I'm the surprised. Ill feeling is still there.
I'm surprised Mike Keenan didn't pull the goaltender up. Gallant's just teeing off on somebody. Holy smoke. That Chelios?
It might be. Yeah.
That's for the Fedorov incident, see? Gallant, he must have hit him about 8-10 times. Now Graham's trying to get Racine to go. Marchmont's in there. Heidemann, Probert, and Sutter on the outside. Now Probert's going to come over and put a halt to it all by grabbing a hold of Graham, saying, that's enough, pal.
Chelios is trying to get away from the linesman. Chelios has already had his altercation with Gallant. Pateman's got to get him to the dressing room, and Chelios wants to be careful that he doesn't abuse the official. Chelios is upset because he feel, and perhaps rightfully so, that the linesman had him tied up and did not have, the linesman's partner didn't have Gallant tied up, and that allowed Gallant to get in some free shots. There's still some conversation going on down there. And Bob Probert on the ice with all that breaking out.
Yeah.
And still has the gloves on and a hold of the stick. You know, after the incident in Boston last month, early in the month of November, when Probert nearly got the 10-game suspension, you know, he said, I really have to be a lot smarter in situations like that to break out when it isn't really absolutely necessary to get involved. And Probert probably made a wise decision here tonight not getting involved.
The delayed penalty being...
There was the stick by Vincelette.
Vincelette got Chiasson right up in the groin, then a two-hander across the side of the knee, and Chiasson returned and he pokes him. Really gives him a smack in the head. So there was a Detroit penalty being called at the time. Gallant on the upper left of your screen. Gallant and Chelios are the two on the outside, right? So here, right here, is where Gallant and Chelios.
Boy, he got about seven or eight whackos in there, didn't he?
Next time these two teams get together, Mick, will be on December the 29th at Chicago Stadium, and we'll have that game for you right here on Fox 50.
Happy holidays, everybody, early, by the way.
Oh, it's not too early.
Christmas will be on us before we know it.
I already put the tree up.
Well, Gerard Gallant and Chelios weren't in much of a Christmas spirit there. They're wailing away.
Well, the Michigan Bell Variety Series is coming to the Fox Theater, and look at the list of performers. Engelbert Humperdinck, Roger Whittaker, The Magic of David Copperfield, Victor Borge, and Liza Minnelli, all at the Fox Theater. And tickets for the Michigan Bell Variety Series available at the Fox Box Office, Joe Louis Arena Box Office, and all Ticketmaster locations.
Another score coming up on the board across the way, the Islanders and the Blues. 7-7 final. Or the,
no, they're
overtime.
I think
overtime.
They're going into overtime.
Overtime.
Well, there's a 5-minute penalty up for Gerard Gallant, and it'll be interesting to see what this 5-minute major is for. With everything else that went on down there. Now, that's the only penalty that's up on the board. And maybe that was the original call. I'm not sure.
Well, there's only 28 seconds left in this game.
See if we can pick up Bud Lynch.
Chris Chelios, two for roughing. Number 17, Dan Vincelette, two for roughing. Detroit penalties, number 17, Gerard Gallant, 5 minutes for fighting. Detroit's number three, Steve Chazon, 2 minutes for boarding plus 2 minutes for roughing.
Points in with the Red Wing win here. It's just a matter of it's all over.
Well, Gallant got the extra 5 minutes for the only 5 minutes there for fighting. All the others were 2 minute minors. Here's a chance for the Hawks off a scramble with 11.6 seconds to go, but the whistle blows. Back to Yzerman. Yzerman at the top of the circle. Sends it to Fedorov. That went by him. Picked up. Chazon's shot was blocked. And the Nordiques able to clear. Sakic racing after it, but Racine is there to get it to Chazon. Quick pass now for Yzerman. Yzerman across the line. It deflects into the Quebec zone. Nordiques
off the line. Tried to stuff it in front. Intercepted by Benn. He clears it ahead.
Nordiques have an opportunity here. Smale shorthanded. That's a shot zone. He missed it. All the way to center ice. Gallant tips it ahead for Yzerman. And the two defensemen, Willanen and Finn, close that up as Willanen upset with Yzerman swinging the stick at him, and they have words behind the play. Meanwhile, Chevalier behind the net. Got it to Nicholas Lidstrom, and here comes Fedorov. Fedorov with three jerseys, blue jerseys around him. Got it to Ray Sheppard. Sheppard settles it down, moves it across. McCrimmon shot blocked in front by Finn. And Smale waited a bit too long, but he was able to clear it all the way down the ice. Half a minute left in the Gusarov penalty. 7:25 to go in the first period. No score. Lead pass for Lidstrom. Lidstrom drives it.
Well, Probert gets a break here. 6 seconds left in the Quebec penalty. And Adam Foote got his foot in the road. And watch what happened. Thugnut can't handle the Yzerman shot. Probert just wheels around and banks it right in off the left foot of number 52, Adam Foote. And it ricochets right into the net for the first goal of the hockey game. And Bob Probert, very quietly actually, staying right in there. You see it, his 12th goal.
And of course, he's missed. Back to Gallant, who was taken down by Smale. No call made by Dvorsky, and the Nordiques will just dump it in to try to kill time in this period. Chevalier plays it up the boards, and it's cleared out of there by Kevin Miller. So a late power play goal by Probert, set up by Fedorov and Yzerman. And the Red Wings really had no way to get to his forehand unless he pulled up and tried to go short side.
Yep. Carson's had two great scoring chances in this hockey game.
Well, the two goals the other night snapped.
It was Eisenbart all the way as we were screened with Fedorov coming to the middle.
Fedorov got the rebound. That's two rebounds now that Tugnut's given up, and both of them have ended up in the net. And it was Fedorov started the play. Garpenlov did a good job. You don't see him until now, but he made it a three-man rush. And there's Fedorov banging the rebound through and underneath Ronnie Tugnut right there. Garpenlov did a very good job. He started the play out over by the Quebec bench.
Nolan just ran over top of McCrimmon after they went out of your picture right there. And what a stop that was by Tugnut on Garpenlov.
I believe the Nordiques have called a timeout here, Mick.
I didn't hear who was credited with the...
Now gets it over to Lidstrom, back to McCrimmon. One times it, knocked down in front by Sheppard, and it ends up on the corner. 43 seconds left in the power play. Here's Sheppard right out in front, lifted it over the top of the net. Wings getting some great chances on this power play. McCrimmon goes to Yzerman. Yzerman back to McCrimmon. Over to Lidstrom at the left point. McCrimmon will one time it again. That hit the Quebec defenseman in front. And the Nordiques able to clear. 20 seconds left in the penalty to Hupp. 7:43 left in the second period. Wings with a 2-0 advantage. Here's Yzerman on the move. He'll carry into the Nordique zone. Drops it back now for Fedorov. Fedorov, cross ice for Racine. Wrist shot. That hit somebody in front. Ended up wide of the net. Yzerman sends it back. Racine pinched in. The Nordiques able to clear. The penalty to Hupp has expired as Chiasson catches up to it. Plays it off the boards. Deflects out center ice. That plays onside. Yzerman trying to get by Tatarinov, who pokes it away. Now it's picked up by Probert. Probert drops it back for Fedorov. Fedorov back for Probert. It was tipped away, and up the middle it comes to Sackett. Good play by Chiasson to break it up center ice. Racine backhands it over the top of the Quebec goal. Probert is there. Drops it now for Burr. Probert in deep as the puck is slapped up the boards by the Nordiques. Probert catches up to it. Fedorov sends it back for Burr. Back for Fedorov. Fedorov between the circle. Passes across as Chiasson tried to redirect it. Chiasson centering pass. Did not get through. Probert again. Working hard in deep with Burr. It comes to Fedorov. He slides it across for Chiasson. Let's the shot go. And the save by Tugnut. He hangs on.
Boy, the Quebec Nordiques really standing around watching Big Bob Probert cruise in the corners, and they got some great scoring. You believe it?
John Burr goes off the big line with Yzerman and Fedorov. Perhaps because he did not do what Brian Murray expected of him in that first period, and he does the only thing you can do when a coach makes the move. He goes out and scores a goal.
I'll show you, coach. Tell you what, though, Brent Fedick was in full speed and made this thing all happen. Kerr goes for the front of the net, draws some attention. It went right through everybody. And then Burr put it between the legs of Ron Tugnut to make it 3-0.
Had to dump it back and look out.
Racine wasn't any more than 15 feet away from him. He looks to be all right. He does wear the half shield.
Yeah,
I think it caught him around the mouth area.
Got Miller cutting for the net. And the Red Wing captain couldn't get that puck to lay down for him. Now it's recovered by number 11, Owen Nolan, who had two assists in the victory the other night against Boston. And here he is again. Nolan into the Detroit zone. Drops for Gusara. Cross-ice pass, Sackett in the corner. Couldn't control it. Lidstrom plays it up the boards. Burr able to chop it all the way back into the Quebec end. Fedick skating hard after it one more time. And Tugnut played it up the boards, taken away by Burr. Tried to dump it back quickly toward the net. Nordiques do not even go after the puck.
No.
Fedick comes up with it.
They're half asleep right now, Quebec.
Now Sundin goes cross ice. Baker cannot collect the pass. Konstantinov will clear it back the other way. Down to half a minute left of the Chiasson penalty. Under 2 minutes left in the second period. Stay with us in our second intermission. We'll have Redmond's corner. And the rest of our second intermission activities, including highlights from period number two. In the corner, Sundin had it knocked away by Konstantinov. He plays it around Fedorov. Nice clear for Sean Burr. Burr drops it back for Racine. Fedorov is coming up late. He gets the drop pass to Racine, and the shot was blocked wide of the Quebec goal. And you just hear the crowd, the oohs and ahs. They gain momentum as the Wings carry the puck into the zone, and they anticipate that nice creative offensive movement. As the penalty to Chiasson has expired, he's out of the box and sends it across for Yzerman. Let's the long shot go, and the save by Tugnut. Fedorov drop. Make it 4-0.
You can hear the clank of the goalpost all the way up here in the broadcast booth. But a very bad giveaway. I'm not sure whether it was Tatarinov or not, but he had a very listless shift out there, number four. And Lidstrom, who was already starting to back up because Quebec had possession, just stepped up into the hole and kept the puck inside the line and smoked it past Ronnie Tugnut.
There you see the fifth of the year for number five. He has an assist.
Tipped just wide of Tugnut. Tugnut started to go to his left. It was tipped back to his right. And the Red Wings are incoming.
Behind Tugnut, who's back there to stop it. Tugnut plays it himself up the boards. Baker gets a stick on it, but it's held in by Shepherd. Cross ice for Carson. Winds up for a drive. That didn't miss by much. Sometimes Carson, when he shoots the puck, it looks like it accelerates after it leaves a stick.
Didn't look like a heavy shot.
Not like a goal stick up in the air. Bang, right there. And it went off Reichel and up underneath the crossbar to open the scoring. And Shepherd just continues to roll. Not even a question whether it was up around the shoulders or not. It was about weight high.
Tugnut. Carson tried to
stick up there, and it laid right there.
It's a 50-50 shot, whether it goes in the net or it happens to hit Walmsley, and it did and stayed right in the crease. He picked it up with a blocker hand. He didn't quite get it up high enough. He likes to go right up underneath the bar, and this one got a little over the waist and right into the glove of Rick Walmsley as Eisenman's fed by Lidstrom. Watch that big hole to the left of the goalie. See that? He was trying to get it up. He wanted to go about a foot and a half higher.
Walmsley was moving that way.
Yes, he was. Yeah, he was, and he was cutting it down, but there was a hole there. If Eisenman gets it right up underneath the bar at the four-foot level. Deflection here. Hit the junction of the crossbar on the goalpost and came down back over Chevy's left shoulder and out in the crease, and then Marsh gets in the room. No, Roberts took it on his backhand off the end boards of the shot by Neuendijk. And as he was going backwards across the front of the net, watch this. Roberts coming from the right. Here he comes. He's going backwards, and it deflected in. There was the original shot by number 10, Gary Roberts, right there. And it just deflects off Chevalier as he pulled off that short side goalpost. And 27 seconds in, the Flames have tied the hockey game.
Well, the Wings failed to clear the zone. Neuendijk held it in. His shot went just wide. Neuendijk will get the only assist on Roberts, 20th of the year, just 27 seconds into the second period. We got a 1-1 hockey game. Krimmen from behind his own net. Starts it back now. Lead pass for Eisenbart. Skips in wide of Walmsley. Eisenbart taken down to prevent him from touching the puck. And the icing call is made.
Trying to set Conceal. Pretty rambunctious in the first period. I don't remember him being that way with Minnesota near as much. Big defenseman. Flames have always gone for the big players, even going back to Jim Poplinski, who retired a couple of years ago, and of course Joel Otto, number 29 at center, and they got some big boys out of the lineup tonight.
Lucille lets a shot go. Chevalier saw it all the way.
That stung him on the knee. He went down early, and that puck caught him right in the exposed part of the leg above the pad. Chevalier shaking that right leg right now.
And the former Calgary Flame, McClellan, made a great move on Natchez, I believe, at the Flames' blue line of the Red Wings, back up by a goal.
Boy, Ray Sheppard is on fire against this team. Walmsley got a pretty good piece of the puck after it came off the stick of Ray Sheppard. The move was at center ice. Walmsley standing up, or Natchez, rather, standing up. And McClellan went to the outside and got by him right there. He heard Sheppard call to him. And look at, he's trying to go there, but he knows he can't get it across. Boom, last second, and underneath Walmsley. Red Wings lead by one again.
Another look at it there, and Sheppard second of the night, 15th of the year, and his sixth against
teams on 16 games and only had one loss. Plays like that, and that play was really started out when Fedorov took the loose puck at center ice and darted into the hole. He saw an opening and then gave it over to Eisenbart. It was loose on the right side. And you know what the Flames are arguing? That Fedorov was in the crease. And you know what? I don't think there's any question that he was in the crease. But with the new ruling, the way they're calling the rule now, if it's not really came out and poke-checked him for all purposes, watch the stick come out here right about now. Threw the big goal stick out, and the puck just slid right into the right pad of Stern, because Chevalier's stick actually hit the stick of Ron Stern.
After the turnover, center ice had gotten back to within one.
Well, that's a giveaway. I believe it was Steve Yzerman that had a pass intercepted. Now, it's Yzerman right there, not a pass, but he tried to stick handle through Makarov, and there was only one teammate back. And a nice play by Neuendijk and Makarov, as they make no mistake at the other end of the ice. A little transition game, and bingo, it's a 3-2 hockey game right there.
Fourth of the year for Makarov, who did not play much at all.
But right there. No, it hit him. He looked back. He thought it was past him. He looked back, but it hit him and came back in front of him. Right there as it hits
the
there
ice, it is.
Just
yep.
In front
and
of the crease.
Just puts the pads together right there. Getting some help from Osiecki, who tucked it underneath his right pad. And Eisenbach.
I'm not sure if Fedorov
tightening up, saying, boy, I knew, I thought I had it in the short side, up high, and I missed the net. Put it over top. Here's Shepard. Watch him wheel around with a backhander right here. Oh, Wamsley with the blocker and the goal stick. Fedorov tried to get it underneath his arm that time. Comes out in front, rips another one. That's the one that went up over top of the net. With Wamsley. Detroit. Esbart not getting everything on that shot. You see it laying in behind Wamsley right there. He doesn't know where it is, but...
Up Tim Chevalier! At 18:30 of the third period.
Red Wings kind of got crossed up at the far blue line as the Flames came down. Roberts made a very good move at the line to cut into the middle and leave it for Makarov, who just snapped it up over top of Tim Chevalier. Watch the move right there. Comes back between McCrimmon and Yzerman, and Makarov just split up the middle and let it go one time and ties this hockey game with a minute and a half to go.
The Roberts got tied up there and really got pulled off the puck, and the Flames got a break but took advantage of it. Second. Flames win another one. They sweep the Flames.
Unbelievable. He's just shaking his head going, do you believe the speed that that kid showed in that flight? I think Fedorov got chopped when he went through there on the arm. Pretty good, but I mean, he was like he was shot out of a cannon. He went up the middle. You could see with his speed and the speed that he had going at the time that he was going to beat the two Flame defensemen. It was just a matter of whether he was going to be able to score a goal or not. And boy, what a hockey game that kid played tonight.
Well, there's no question about whether or not he and Yzerman and Burr can play on the road. We talk about the circumstances, and those numbers don't always tell everything.
Radmar shoots the puck. It hits a Flame stick right there, Gilmore, and bounces dead up the middle. Now Fedorov is gone right there. They both get a stick on him, and it's a backhand. Looks like it goes under and through the legs of Rick Wamsley. And the Red Wings, for the second time this year, have beaten the Flames here in overtime. Here's a angle look at it. Now watch this thing open up. Here he goes. He's going to close down now, but not quick enough for Fedorov. He's just gone. And the Red Wings extend their streak to 17 games with only one loss.
Unbeaten in their last six.